Manufacturing plants are known for their assembly lines. Parts are sequentially added one by one by mechanically moving the assembly from workstation to workstation until the final assembly is produced. The digestive system works in just the opposite fashion, a disassembly line. Assume you ate a cheeseburger for lunch. The calories you consumed in that meal consist of three main macromolecules: proteins, carbohydrates, and fats. These macromolecules are mechanically and chemically broken down into their smaller subunits and absorbed into cells as they are propelled through the digestive system. In order to complete this function, food is mixed with a variety of secretions that arise from the digestive tract itself and accessory digestive organs, such as the pancreas, gallbladder, and salivary glands. Take the protein from the meat in your cheeseburger, for example. It is disassembled into subunits called amino acids, which can then be absorbed into cells of the pancreas and used to make insulin. Similarly, the starch in the bun must be disassembled into glucose before it can be absorbed and used by our cells to make energy. Ultimately, parts of the meal that cannot be disassembled and/or absorbed by the body are excreted in feces. You may find it interesting to know that the digestive system is regulated to absorb all the nutrients we consume, whether we need them or not. In this module, we will discuss both the major and accessory organs involved in digestion and how these organs contribute to the mechanical and chemical breakdown of macromolecules as they make their way through the digestive tract. Along the way, we will also explore the mechanisms involved in the absorption of nutrients across the gut epithelium. In a later module, we will discuss how digestion is regulated. Believe it or not, the digestive system has its own mini brain.